Hi, it's Stuart Sutton at Remax One. I hope you're having a great day. What real estate agents will not tell you will have a dramatic effect on the successful sale of your home. You see, there's four distinct steps: pricing, preparation, presentation, and promotion. And we're going to cover each of these. We're going to start with pricing. Pricing your home is the first step toward a successful sale. What real estate agents will not tell you can have a dramatic impact on the success of your sale. This is not based on a negative concept. You see, in any industry, there's things that the consumer may never know because it's not shared with them by the people in that industry. There are just certain things that real estate agents aren't going to tell you. One, because they may not know, and two, because it might hurt their chances of getting your business. Well, I think it's important for you to know these. I encourage you to ask me if you decide to interview me personally. The first problem in pricing your home is that an agent may not be familiar with the comparable sales they're using to place a value on your home, and that can result in a very inaccurate valuation. But that's something that they're probably not going to admit. You see, there's different sections, different builders, different ages. I just did a valuation for a homeowner where another agent had given them a completely different valuation, but when I looked at the comparables they used, they were from other sections that sold at a very different price range. Agents have to be familiar with what they're using as support for your value. A different section of your neighborhood may have older homes. It may have a higher quality builder. It may be a better location. There could be any number of factors. That doesn't mean that you should always only use homes in a certain section, because every neighborhood's different. What I'm saying is familiarity with the neighborhood is important, and familiarity with valuation is important. Give an example. Homes on a greenbelt typically will sell at a different price than homes that are not on a greenbelt. Homes that back up to a golf course, homes on cul-de-sacs, homes that have three-car garages. There's a lot of differences that you want to make sure. One section of a neighborhood might have a different value range than another section. The biggest source of this problem is agents who list all over the market. I recently saw an agent who had a listing out near Lakeway, one in Buda, one in Georgetown. This is true. I just don't see how they can have the familiarity they need in order to best provide service to the people they're representing. The second problem is too many agents, most agents, use one method, and that's the price per square foot method. It's inherently inaccurate. If you think about it, one 3,000 square foot house is just simply not the same value as another 3,000 square foot house unless there's a coincidence. What if one 3,000 square foot house has been kept in mint condition and another one needs a lot of deferred maintenance? What if one has a lot of improvements that aren't necessarily visible from the street or known to everybody and another one has no improvements? There's some very dramatic factors that affect value. The number of garages affect value, the number of baths, the improvements, kind of improvements, number of improvements, amount of improvements. Contrary to popular belief, pools add value. I just did one in a neighborhood where pools in that neighborhood sold for an average of 11.4% more than homes without pools. Age affects value. Remodeling, when it was done, how it was done, location. There's so many things. Square footage does affect value, but it's only one factor. If you're dealing with an agent who is just focused on price per square foot, they may be coming in with a value that is just not accurate for you. Valuation, when I say it's a problem, a lot of people think I mean overpricing. No, underpricing is a problem too. If you overprice and stay in the market too long, your value is going to come down and you're going to leave money on the table. If you underprice from the beginning and sell really, really fast, you're going to leave money on the table. You want to price your home so that it gets the best price for you without leaving money on the table. And in a hot market, that is sometimes a little harder to do, but it can certainly be done. The third problem, the number itself, and here's what I mean by that. I never list a home ever at $199.9 or $749.9 or $599. That's old school pricing. Any agent who tries to convince you to do that simply isn't paying attention. If you have a home that is valued near a price band, put it on the price band. The price bands are the hundreds, the fifties, and the quarters. $750, $400, $600. Do not price it at $449.9. Think about this. If you price your house at $599, someone's searching $500 to $600, they just found your house at $599. But if they're searching $600 to $700, they're not going to find it. Why wouldn't you want them to? If someone's searching $600,000 to $700,000 and you're priced at $599, you're probably a house they want to know about. If you price your home at $600, They'll find you whether they search from 5 to 600, 550 to 600, 6 to 650, 6 to 700. The number you choose will dramatically affect how many people see your home online. And any agent who doesn't agree with this simply isn't paying attention. Here's the one I mentioned a little bit earlier. Even a hot market, agents tend to price aggressively. That's okay. But if they price too high, thinking, hey, any price will work because the market's so hot, that's just not the case. Having a home priced too high, even in a hot market, will be recognized by home buyers. They establish value. Home buyers see other homes, and if they're looking at a certain value range, and other homes are obviously a better value, they're not going to make an offer on a home that is priced too high. Time on the market will bring that price down and eventually affect the price that will be obtained for that home. I know it sounds contradictory, but pricing too high can actually end up in getting a lower price later. Obviously, pricing too low can result in leaving money on the table. The four areas, let me summarize, are having an agent who's not familiar with the sales comparables and using comparables that really are not appropriate because they're not familiar with your area. Secondly, the price per square foot method is inherently inaccurate. An agent who just uses that is someone you might want to reconsider. Third, the number you choose, the number for the price, will dramatically affect how many people see your home online. And last but not least, even in a hot market, it's easy to overprice a home. Make sure you avoid doing that. Once again, this is Stuart Sutton at Remax One. Thanks for taking the time to listen. I hope to meet you soon. Call, text, email if I can do anything at all. I hope you can experience the new level of real estate service that I provide. Make it a powerful day. Bye-bye.